go.
What's that? Who's there?
It's me, Spyro.
And the former god of tall plains, Sparks.
You don't carry the stench of Cinder's beast, so you must be friends.
We are. And who are you?
I'm Moliere, leader of the Manwer Smalls. But I'm not much of a leader anymore. Those are my people who aren't manning for Cinder are holed up in their caves, scared out of their little wits, waiting for Buzzard Big to blur. Which shouldn't be long. If you would help me free them, perhaps there's something I could do for you?
I don't know. We're here to rescue a big friend of ours.
Is he a Matte Dragon?
Yes. Why?
Because I know where he's been kept. In the mines near a large labor camp, where my own brother, ex-humor, turns away. We can help each other.
Well, which way do we go? What should we do next?
Oh, it's simple enough, but we've got to hurry. Buzzard Big is getting more unstable by the minute. We must clear these caves before we can help your friend.
And you're asking him for directions? Wow, talk about blind leading the blind.
Forget him, Moliere. We're in.
Thank you.
It was nothing.
Hey, no problem, pal.
Well, you did your part. Now I will do mine. Your friend is being kept in the center of the volcano, past the labor camp where my brother, Exhumer, is working. Find him and let him know we're friends, and he'll tell you how to proceed.
How will we know, Exhumer?
Yeah, all you manner wee smalls look the same to me.
Oh, you will know him. Trust me. He is the most cantankerous, hard-nosed man with small around. Whatever you do, don't get on his bad side.
Thank you.
I bet you can't ring that bell.
Why would I want to?
Oh, you're scared.
I'm not scared.
Oh, the big special dragon is scared of the mean old bell. Oh, I didn't know that. I'm sorry. Oh, no. Oh, I'm sorry, baby. Why don't I get your pillow you laid out? Spyro, can you hear me? Are you okay, buddy? Hey, listen, forget about those cracks I made about your fatness and your being purple and stupid and fat. All right? Just get out of there, please, Spyro. Don't be dead.
Did you say something?
Me? No. No, I was talking out loud, thinking of my day I gotta do.
Well, just thought I heard something before I blasted my way out.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, no. Must be hearing things.
Worthless waste of flesh, let's go. We gotta hop on steam and get back to that flea-bitten dragon. The crystal should be almost ready, and the volcano's right on the brink.
Come on, Sparks, we've gotta catch them.
Ha ha!
learn how to drive this thing.
How hard can it be? It's on rails.
Oy, famous last words.
Wait, we're on your side.
More likely spies for the conductor, or that flying beast, Cinder.
No, Moliere sent us.
My brother is alive.
He sure is, pal. He's all safe and sound. But I gotta say, he's the friendly one in the family.
I'm sorry. In these dark times, one can't take chances. So, Moliere is alive. Oh, wonderful news. But why did he send you here?
Well, he said you might be able to tell us where our friend Terrador is.
If he's a big dragon, I certainly can. The majority of the Manwer Smalls are kept here in this camp, forced to live above ground and mine for cinder. And there are rumors that your dragon friend is being kept somewhere inside, in the darkest pits of the volcano. All of us are doomed.
Not if we have anything to say about it.
What do you mean?
Yeah, what do you mean?
I mean, we're going to free the Manwer Smalls, venture to the darkest pits of Boisetbig, and find Terrador.
Then, it's off to karaoke.
Let's do it.
Two crazy kids found each other.
Yes, at last! Thanks to you.
We're just disappointed you didn't leave any fun for us.
Maybe next time. So now, which way to Terrador?
That way, but be careful. The conductor and his maniacal locomotive will surely be close by.
When you say be careful, does that mean try not to die? I'm trying to do that anyway.
Comex humor. We must get all the Manwer Smalls underground, where they belong.
Yes, it won't be long now.
Hey!
Let's keep trying.
Big dragon being held prisoner in the center of an explosive volcano? I'm guessing that's Terrador.
Careful, it's never this easy.
After the last two times, you're not gonna get an argument from me, Chief. Oh, here we go again.
You're a little late, fella. The crystal's already charged and the volcano's ready to blow. Before it does, me and Steve here are gonna take great pleasure in running you down.
Thank you. the purple dragon lives.
He's got a name, you know.
Yes, my name is Spyro. And you must be Terrador.
Yes, yes I am. And I must say I never thought I'd live to meet you, Spyro.
Look, I'd love to sit here and hug everybody and chit-chat, but how about we leave before the volcano blows us up?
You're right. I've got to tell the others what Cinder is up to.
Let's go. Right behind you. Actually, I'm right in front of you.
Run!
Look, when the guy says run, I think he knows something.
Spyro, fly like you've never flown before! I'll go back to the temple for help!
We've got to find them. Help ignite us.
They're gone, Spyro. There's nothing we can do.
I don't care. Ignitus wouldn't leave me.
Spyro, he's right.
I'm right? Oh my god, that's a first.
Yes. You'd never find them in this mess. And you're not ready to face Cinder yet. Time to fight will come, but it is not now.
I guess you're right. Let's go. It's my fault. I failed Ignitus when he needed me most. It's just that the sight of Cinder so close just...
Made your heart stop? Put ice in your veins? Scared the crud out of you?
Yeah, something like that.
All warriors feel fear at one time or another, Spyro. There's no shame in that.
Yes, it's a proven scientific fact that the quotient between adrenaline and trepidation...
Voltaire, please. I believe our good friend here was trying to make a point.
Thank you, Cyril. What I was going to say is that all warriors feel fear, Spyro, but only the most valiant among us can face that fear and master it. From what I saw of you on Munitions Forge, you are one such warrior. Young dragon, now is the time to complete your training. Now is the time to face your fear. Come.
Am I the only one still petrified?
Spyro, come here.
Itself is now within your grasp. Let's begin. Always be gracious in victory, Spyro.
Come over here.
Might be hope for you yet, young dragon.
Over here.
Ignitus may have been right about you.
This way, oh Mauve One.
You might prove to be a true warrior yet.
Spyro, come here.
Done well, Spyro.
Yes, yes, pat on the back, good going, all that other rubbish, but we've got to get moving here.
Oh, Cyril is terribly obnoxious, but in this case, he happens to be right, Terrador. Ignitus is the final piece to Cinder's puzzle. If that last crystal is powered, the portal will open, and we'll all be done for.
I know. When I was on Munitions Forge, I overheard the conductor say that Cinder's final preparations would take place at her lair, where she lives in solitude among the clouds and the towers. I am certain that's where she's taken Ignitus.
We have to go. Come on.
I'd give anything to go with you, young warrior. But that crystal sapped the last of my will. I fear my fighting days are over.
Every generation must pass the torch to the next, Terrador. Our time is done.
Yes, it is Spyro's time to shine. Now go to it, young dragon.
Yes, sir.
Wow, you guys make even me want to face Cinder. Did I say that out loud?
Cinder's lair is where hope goes to die, Spyro. A dark, foreboding place in which Cinder broods and skulks and plans her next assault. You must make your way to her fortress, where I'm sure Ignitus is being held.
Next time I say that I want to face Cinder, why don't you go ahead and punch me in the mouth?
No problem.
Terrador made it sound like this place is uninhabited.
Now what fun would that be? Come on, we've got to take them out.
Thank you. work, big guy. Now for the next one.
There.
Ah! heart breaking out.
Come on, Ignitus is waiting.
Thank you.
Ignitus needs us.
I'm not complaining. I'm just saying it would be easier if she was smaller. A lot smaller.
Yeah! Oh,
Spyro. Spyro.
What?
I don't like this. It feels like she's baiting us. I'm getting smarter.
Spyro! Destroy the crystal! Quickly!
Let's get him out of here before Cinder gets back.
If only it were that easy, little one.
So big.
Time you learned how complicated life can be.
Run! Spyro! Save yourself!
Not this time. This time I fight.
Bring it. In this way. Now, where was I?
Does she ever use doors?
There was something in her eyes, Ignitus. Something familiar.
There should be, Spyro. You and Cinder share more than you know. It's time I told you the truth. All of it. You see, after I took your egg to the Silver River, I returned to the grotto to find utter chaos. The other guardians had been overrun, and all the other eggs had been smashed by the Dark Master's forces. All except one. You see, the Dark Master was torn. He wanted to destroy all the eggs to prevent the birth of the Purple Dragon. But he also needed a dragon.
Why would he need a dragon?
Because, Spyro, only one born in the year of the dragon could open the portal that served as the Dark Master's prison.
Cinder?
I'm afraid so.
But if we come from the same place, why is she so... so...
evil? Monstrous? Big? Sexy? Oops, did I say that?
Because, Spyro, after the night of the raid, she was corrupted by the Dark Master's poisonous powers, twisted by his evil lore. She's become the Dark Master's monster.
But why? What does this Dark Master want?
He wants to be freed from the portal of convexity, to wreak havoc across the realms. And if Cinder gets there, he just might succeed. I'm afraid we might be too late.
No, I refuse to give up. I'm going to stop Cinder and the Dark Master.
Wait, you heard the dragon, Spyro. He said, too late. We'll get him next time. Come on, champ. You did a great job, and let's take five.
No, I'm ready. Now!
Okay, Spyro, you're right. At the very least, you have to try. If the Dark Master escapes, a shadow will fall over the land. And who knows what will happen then. May the ancestors look after you. May they look after us all. Convexity acts as an airlock between our world and the dark realms beyond.
You must stop Cinder before she inserts the final crystal and activates the portal, freeing the Dark Master.
Hurry, I have a feeling you're gonna see a whole lot more. Come on.
Master returns.
We're too late.
Persistent little fellow, aren't you? This is where it really ends.
Bring it.
No mercy this time.
I can't watch this.
It's time to unleash the true dragon within you.
Just like me.
Dude, we gotta get out of here now.
I can't leave her behind. I've got to save her.
What? Save the beast that's been trying to kill us?
Yeah, that wasn't her fault. She was being used by the Dark Master. Can go.
I'm right behind you, buddy.
Mommy, fluff my pillow.
Feeling better, Spyro?
Not really, Ignitus. That battle drained every last bit of my strength. I can hardly lift my head.
Yes, it will take some time for your powers to return. But they will in time, young dragon. They will in time. Cinder, ever since I failed the night of the raid, I've dreamt of this day.
It wasn't just you, Ignitus. We all failed.
Be that as it may, we're together again now. Thanks to Spyro. Well done, young dragon.
Thanks, Ignitus. But we still don't know what's happened to the Dark Master.
No matter, Spyro. There will be time to talk of the Dark Master later. Now it's time to be grateful for your success.
His success? Hey, what about me? Just because a bunch of weird stuff doesn't fly out of my mouth doesn't mean I didn't help you now.
Yeah, you were a big help, Sparks, no doubt about it. But just for the record, a lot of weird stuff does come out of that little mouth of yours.
And what the heck is that supposed to mean? You know, I don't need this. I could have stayed with the llama people, whatever, where I was appreciated, but no. No, I just had to help the poor helpless dragons rid the world of evil. What a mistake that was, because I get no thanks. No respect, no love, no credit.
My goodness. And I thought Voltaire talked a lot.
I left home too, you know. I'm a little guy, yeah, that's right. Maybe you haven't noticed. Things are a lot bigger to me than they are to you. And did I back away? Uh-uh. Nah. Why? Because I got moxie. I'm a tough cookie. I got class.
I got a
little frog in my throat. As I was saying, on tall plains, they knew a good thing when they saw it. They recognized the value of a quality dragonfly like me. But here I get nothing. Not even a thanks. Hey, how you doing? Good, let me buy you a drink. I should go back to the swamp. Mom will make it all good. Mommy always does.
Thank you.
See anything, Spyro?
No. But I've got a bad feeling.
Me too.